Hello students, in the virtual class we learn about the attributes of the P tag. All the attributes are done here. We learn all the attributes: HR tag attribute, body tag attribute, then P tag attribute, and hopefully that you practice for that. Now we are going to learn the next one that I already introduced you in the virtual class, that is the list. First list is the order list and second is the unordered list. What is the meaning of list? When you are writing some of the points that will be comes in form of the list. For example, name of the subjects: first math, second science, third English, like that. So I already introduced that of the things, so now we are going to do the practical for that. So we are going to learn the ordered list here. In order list, the points are numbered in the sequence like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Types of attributes are first. Before typing of attributes, I want to show you the output of that. I already made a one program for you in the notepad and name is the order list here. First, I will show you the output, then show you how to use the OL. Okay, this is the work program order list, and here you can see the output also. Clearly, order list means this is the heading. I bold it, that's why it will become in the bold form. Then list of the subject: maths, English, Hindi, SS, science, computer, Sanskrit or Gujarati. So why this come below maths and English? Just because I'm using here BR tag also. Okay, so for that I'm telling you that you have to be use the OL, means order list. Full form of OL is the order list. Now we have to use the OL for the numbering of the sequence. OL. Okay, OL means it allows to create a list in sequence. So OL open, OL closed. Is it okay? Then we are doing only writing only OL, then it will become say numbering. No, you have to be add one more thing to get the numbers, that is called the LI. LI full form is the list item. LI in front of every topic, every, for example, first is the maths, so you have to write down the LI before the mathematics. Second is the English, so again you have to be write down the LI in front of the English. So I'm copying it. So means nothing matter how many lists you have. You have 100 lists, then in front of the 100 items you have to be write down the LI. LI means list item, means first is the maths, numbering starting with the first maths, second English, third Hindi, fourth SST, like that. So I'm saving it and show you the output here. So here you can see that number will comes in the sequence 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, right? So here I am using the OL, that's why this will be come in form. Now we have to use, we are going to learn the attributes of the OL order list. First is the type. The type of attributes specify the type of numbering. As you can see in the output, the numbering will be start from the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So first is the type, means if you want to start from the Roman, you want to start type the numbers in the Roman forms, and you can write down the type attributes. You can use the type attributes in that condition. Second is the start. We do the practical both combined. The start attributes specify the number of the first point in the list. Here you can also see that in the output, the number will be started from 1. I'm end the list here and I want to write down the second list. But that will be start with the 8th, just because I end with the 7 here. So for that you have to use the attribute start. So there are two attributes of the order list. First is the type, means which type you want. It's not necessary that you can use only numbers or the Roman number. You can also use the alphabets. जैसे कि हम start करते हैं तो कभी कभी sequence में लिखा होता question ही आप देख लो. Question number A, question number B, question number C, like that you can also use the alphabets here. Here is a one example is given. OL type equals to I means Roman number will be started. If you write a I in the capital, that will be output will be given in the capital. If you write with the in the small number, that will be start with the small. Same for the alphabet also. Okay, OL type I means it needs a Roman number start with 5, means that will be compulsory start with 5. This is an output 5, 6, 7, 8. Hopefully that you know what is the Roman number and how to write the Roman number. So first I want to do that. First OL type, you can see it will be start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here I am changing the type. Type equals to, compulsory you have to be write down in the double quote. Simply that I am using the capital I means Roman. Saved. Refresh. You can see it will be converted in the Roman form. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. If you want to write the small I. Here you can see the change again. That will becomes in the Roman. But comes in the small letter. Okay, if I'm writing the capital A, what will be the difference? Starting with the A, B, C, D, E, F, G. If you're writing small A, then that will be also displayed to you. Small A, B, C, D. Simply, that is depend on you, which type of list you want to display it in your web page, right? First attribute is the type that will be here. If you are not writing a type, that will be considered direct a number. Matlab wo number se start karega. I am just remove it here from now. Okay, next is the attribute is the start equals to, whenever you removed it will be start from the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to start this number from 3. What should be happen? You can see it will be start from the 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. Again, I am adding that type equals to A. So it will be started from first is A, second is B, third is C. So this type will be start from the C. Let's see the changes. So here there will be changes C, D, E, F, G, H, I. It's not necessary that you are writing only 3. That is depend on also you. If I am writing down 6. Simple. You can see here the changes. If that will be start from the 6th letter, that is the F. So this is the order list and the attributes of the order list. And I just suggest you please do the practice for this. Just because in the practical exam, there will be a one practical come for the order and the unordered list. So it's necessary for you to practice for this one. Okay students, so I'm end this video and next video I will learn the unordered list. Thank you so much. Have a good day.